Hi everyone up there, this is Josh and welcome to my channel. Thanks for joining. Today I'm going to cover Adobe Express. So you're probably wondering, what is Express? Basically, it's a content creation tool. So you can use it for social media, video, documents, marketing. You can use it across all these different categories here, whatever your social media may be. And you've also got a content editor tool built in. So I'm going to cover all the main features, including that content editor, so you can quickly get up to speed and begin using Express. Let's get started with your content presets. So there's two ways that you can actually search for presets within Express. You can look at them visually here, simply click through any of these different categories and you'll find all the presets that you might need. For example, documents, you've got presentations, reports, brochures, flyers, or if you go to social media, you can see here all the different social media presets that you've got across Instagram or Facebook or YouTube. As you can see here, YouTube video or thumbnail or a short or YouTube banner. So it's very easy and simply you can create from scratch or click it here to create from one of the templates. Now, if you go over here and you click the plus icon, you can see it's going to do the same thing for you, but it's going to give you a list view. So you've got suggested sizes here, and don't forget you can also upload your own media here too. So if you're already working on something, you can simply click this button to upload it directly from your computer, or you can simply click view all, which I strongly suggest. Click view all, and now you can see all of the different presets for all these categories. So across Instagram, for example, or Facebook or YouTube here, as I was just showing you, YouTube banner, display ad, profile ad, thumbnail, and so on. You've also got quick actions under the plus icon. So if I click on that, you can see in the second tab here, if I click on that again, I've now got all these very useful quick actions. So for example, I could remove the background. If I click there, I can now click again and simply select one of my images and open it. And now it's going to quickly remove almost instantly the background. See, now I've got a transparent background. I can download it and I can open the editor, which I'm going to show a bit later. So you've also got the ability to resize an image, caption a video, convert to GIF, MP4, resize a video, even merge videos, generate a QR code. I'll go over that very quickly here. You simply type in your link or your website. You can style it here. You can add a color, for example, make it a bit more unique, and then even select a different file format. So if I go back here, you can see I've got plenty of more options. Text to image, text effects, convert to PNG, convert to JPEG, trim a video, crop a video. So really lots of very, very useful actions here right at your fingertips. Let's continue with a quick tour of the interface. So the top here you can see is search field, and we'll come back to that in just a second. On the right here you can see you can join the community, you can check what kind of membership you have, and you can also go to your account settings over here to manage your account. On the left hand side you've got your major tabs like home, your stuff, explore, schedule, and learn, and we're going to learn more about that in just a second. So let's continue with the search. If I type in robots up here, for example, click enter, you can now see it's going to break out the results across these different categories. So files, which are my work files, templates, photos, videos, backgrounds, and design assets. So that's how it's going to break it out. It's just going to give you some teaser images that you can get started with. If you want to, you can simply click on this arrow to see more, or if you want to see everything in that category, you can simply click on view all or go to the top and you can do the same thing. You can click into any of these categories to see everything that is relevant to that search term. Once you create something, you're going to want to know where to find it. So simply click on your stuff below the home tab, and you're going to find all of your files here. Simply scroll down to browse. You can also search them here if you've got a lot. And you can see I've got some stuff organized in different folders. So you can see I've got four here. You can also add another folder over here. And if you want to, once you hover over a file, you can see if you click on this little box here, you can see it's going to open up a little blue ribbon. So you can edit it here. You can invite others. You can also make a template and you can also delete it. Let's check out the Explore tab next. So if I click there, you can see this is going to bring up all the stock that's available to me in this program. And it's even got different groupings like templates, for example, or photographs. You've got different themes here like wellness, flat lays, people, seasonal, featured, free, pets. So if you go back up, you can see the same thing across video. You've got technology, seasonal, fashion and beauty, small business, food and drink, design assets. Again, you know, it's all organized under brushes, elements, frames. So basically what they're doing is they're presenting all the stock that's available to you under Adobe Express here. When you're ready to publish your content, simply go to the Schedule tab down below here. And now it's going to give you all the options to publish your content across Facebook, Instagram, X, for example, and others. Simply click the Connect button, and it's going to give you instructions on how to connect. You can also learn within the application itself by going to the Learn tab, and now you can see you can explore learning across design, social media, video, photography, document, and even generative AI. So lots of different videos here to check out, and they even give you the timeline. For example, this one's 41 minutes and this one's 5. Let's check out some AI features within Adobe Express next. If I click on the Generative AI tab here, You can see here I've got text to image. So if I type in my prompt here and click generate, it's going to create an image for me. You can see here different examples that you can also play with. So bear with sunglasses in the woods. You can see more over here by clicking on the arrow. I'll give you a quick example, actually. If I click up here, you can see here I typed in an Arctic beach house in summer by the ocean. And this is what it gave me. It actually gave me 4 results. And I picked this one. I thought this was pretty good. To go back here to continue the tour. And under there, under text image, you've got generative fill. So you can upload an image to start. So if you've got an image you want to work with, you can simply, you know, upload it here. Or you can pick one of these to work with. I picked this one, for example. And this is what I got. I changed this to a cork top. And then I also changed this to strawberries over here. So it's very easy to add things. You simply click in there and you can begin editing right away. Below there, you've got text to template. So simply type in your text and generate, or you can work with any one of these, click in there, and you can, you know, change it. Text to text. So you simply type in your prompt here once again and click generate. And now you can see here, liquid mercury. We've got this example, which is pretty cool. Blue cushions, cacti, you know, gold. So you simply have to be very descriptive in what you want to create. And there you go. It's that simple to use. So now that you understand the basic interface, let's take a look at the content editor. And if I click into any of these documents, it's going to open up the content editor. For example, My Robots. Now you can see this is the content editor, and these are going to be the tools that you'll see each time you open up this interface. So you've got the tools on the left-hand side, the top, and the right-hand side. And basically, it's very simple to use. You just go to the top here, for example, if you want to change the background color, click that, and you can now change it to black or white or transparent or any of these colors, really. There's more colors down below. Okay, you can also change the theme colors, for example, the overall theme you're working with by going in here. You can also resize, which is really useful to know, because now if you want to change it to for example, a logo or a flyer or an Instagram reel or, you know, a Facebook post, whatever you like, it's all listed here. Simply click it and then change to resize. So basically, it's that simple. Before you do that, however, just a quick tip. I'm going to close that. If you go over here to add, you can click on duplicate, and this way you won't destroy your original. Simply click duplicate, and it's just going to create another page. Okay, so I'm going to go back over here and show you how I did a quick search. If I type in, for example, into the search here, if I type in robot toys, you can see it's brought up all these different examples. And all you need to do is basically click on anything you like and drag it in. So click and drag and drop. And it's that simple. So let's just drag it there. I'm going to delete that, however. And now if I go back over here to your stuff, you can see this is all of my stuff. These are all of my files here. Branding is here, so I can drag the branding in. And it's also got my folders. So if I continue under here, there's also templates. And I've got my media here as well. So I've got photographs, upload from my devices here, text to images here. And I've also got videos I can upload from my device, or I can search across all these different categories, technology, seasonal, you know, and so on. And I've also got audio. So this is really useful to find here, because you've got the ability to do a voiceover, and you can also upload any soundtracks from your device. And you've also got lots of different options to browse through: acoustic, background, blues, classical, country, dance, electronic, film. It's pretty exhaustive, actually, you know, pop, reggae, religious, and so on. So I'll let you check that out. And you can listen to it first, too, by the way. Simply click the play button and you can hear it. And then all you do is simply click and drag it in. So if I go back over here to text, that's pretty self-explanatory. You've got different text fields here. If you like these graphics, again, you can drag them in. Simply click and drag. Otherwise, you can simply click add your text and it will add a new field. As you can see, I've done that here. It's added the text over there. I'm going to delete that and continue with elements. Over here, you've got different elements that you can use, you know, for example, frames or textures, overlays that, you know, you might be interested in adding, for example, an ocean wave or a feather. Grids, you've also got grids that you can use here. You simply click and drag these over as well, and now all your images will be aligned in the grid format that you can see here. So they've got lots and lots of different formats, but basically you just need to add your photographs, you know, into these different grids. So if we continue here, if I close this and select an image, I want to show you very quickly that you can also adjust each image individually. So I've selected this one. I can change the opacity like so very, very easily. I can also go down here and change the effect. So I've made it red like this, this kind of funny, scary red, but you can change it to anything you like. You can change it to grayscale, you know, blue, etc. I'm going to keep mine as red. Close out of that and click it again to open it. And now you've got the further adjustments down below. Below effects, you've got adjustments. So you can change the contrast, you can change the, you know, the brightness here, change it all the way up to very bright, change the highlights. Okay. So very easy to adjust, or you can reset everything as well. So I'll close out of that. And lastly, over on the right-hand side here, you've got pages. So these pages are going to show all the different iterations that you've created so far. So you can see here, I've got quite a few different iterations. It's taking a minute to upload, but here you go. So these are the different iterations that I've created so far. And if I want to, I can actually adjust things within each iteration too by going to the layers panel. And that's important to know because sometimes you can't grab an object. For example, I can't grab that green robot. I actually have to go into the layers panel and now I can grab him. And now I can go in and I can make further adjustments over here because these objects are obviously layered on top of each other. So as I end this video, I want to share one last image with you. It's called Starry Night by Vincent van Gogh. And as you can imagine, I generated this within Adobe Express, and I think it turned out pretty good. So thanks for watching, and please do subscribe to see more videos like this one. Check out my other videos, and definitely feel free to share this video with others to help them learn. And feel free to add any comments below. I would love that, and I hope to talk soon. Thanks, and bye for now.